Hi guys, welcome back to the channel. If you are new here, welcome. My name is Tariro and I like to do African print DIYs. So without wasting time, let's get straight into today's project. So today's project is going to be this African print dungaree skirt. And this is my fabric. All in all, I used 2 yards of fabric. So this was my fabric. And then the first thing that I did was to cut the main part of the skirt, which was the bottom, and that was basically it. It was 2 yards long and about 24 inches long and about 2 yards wide. Then I took the same block of fabric and then I went onto the sewing machine. So because I want this to be like a simple gathered African print skirt, I went onto the side and then I put my sewing machine on tension zero and then I stitched 2 lines so that I would be able to gather them. So there I was just basically putting those 2 lines. So there are my 2 lines and then after that I folded the block of fabric in half. And then I put those little pegs. So this became the seam at the back. And then I also marked where I was going to put the zip so that I don't stitch over this part. And I just went ahead and I sewed up to that point. After sewing, I now went on to my skirt and then I placed that seam on the center like that. And then I started to gather the skirt now. Then I gathered it to the same length as my waist, which is about 32 inches now. So to make the waistband, I took this 5 inches by 2 yards long piece of fabric. Then I folded the ends inside, so you need some allowance for that. Then I just folded all the edges inside and then I also folded it in half and then I ironed it. Then I now took my waistband and then I started to attach it to the skirt and I just put some pins for this and I put my pins vertically because I want to go and sew with the pins still on. I don't use pegs for this. So after putting in the pins, I just went ahead and then I sewed the waistband down. So the way I was doing this was to just put the gathered part of the skirt in the middle of the waistband. And then I sewed it together, hiding the raw edge of the skirt. And then I now took my zip, which I attached first using some pins. And then at that point I had done a tacking stitch. This makes it easier when I go to sew it on the sewing machine. And then so there was just inserting the zipper foot, then I went ahead to stitch the zip down. So at that point the bottom half of the skirt was basically done, and then I now moved on to the top part of the skirt. Then I took this piece of fabric, which was about half, the width was about half of my waist length, and then I marked down about 3 inches from the center. I just wanted that little shape, I just thought it was cute. So before I went on to sew, I just trimmed that little design. And then I now went ahead and I sewed on those edges just like that. Then I made this little snip so that when I turn it inside out, everything will lie nice and flat. Then I turned it inside out, then I ironed it. Then I also went on to the bottom, then I folded the edges inside, and then I just ironed them. And then for the belts, you need to measure yourself basically and see how long you need your belts to be. And then I just folded and ironed them in that manner. Before I went on to sew them on the sewing machine. So then I went back to that top part of the skirt, and then I had to use a seam ripper to basically make an opening so that I would be able to insert these bands or suspenders. Not sure if I should call them suspenders at this point. I'm just going to call them these bands. And then I inserted them like that, and then I stitched them on the sewing machine. Then after that, I now went on to close the bottom. which I sewed shut. The top part was basically done at that point, and the last step was to just sew on some press studs. And that was basically it. It was quite a simple DIY. So thank you so much for watching this video. Thank you so much if you stuck to the end, and I hope to see you in my next DIY. Don't forget to like, comment, and subscribe. Bye.